Can the MW75 Neuro really boost focus and productivity by reading your brainwaves? To find out, I tested them for 60 days, but I didn't just use them for work. I also forced Neurable AI's EEG headphones to scan my brain while getting drunk, watching adult videos online, and taking a nap. In that order, multiple times, for science.
Science rules.
I did notice something big right away. Most of the cost of these things is actually going toward the audio hardware. The headphones are manufactured by a company called Master and Dynamic, a reputable headphone company known for their active noise canceling wireless headphones. The MW75 is their latest model and it starts at $600. And that's the standard model. No EEG capabilities or anything like that. So for just $100 more, the MW75 Neuro is sort of like the upgraded version of that with the EEG sensors and access to Neurable AI's focus tracking app. Honestly, I think that's a very good price for the upgrade, but only if the headphones are good. If the audio sucks, the whole value proposition is shot. So we're going to check that out together in a second. But it is worth mentioning, there is actually a way to get the MW75 Neuro a lot cheaper. So I'll drop some info on that in the description down below. I want to be transparent here. I am not an audiophile. But to me, the headphones do feel very high quality. They're built with lightweight anodized aluminum, touch-sensitive tempered glass, soft leather, and memory foam ear pads. The audio quality on the MW75 Neuro is very crisp and clear. I would play a song for you, but I'd get a copyright strike. I was previously using the Apple AirPods Pro, and the noise cancellation on these is better than on my AirPods. It really does a great job of tuning out any distracting background noise. The built-in microphones also work perfectly for taking calls, so it's pretty seamless to hop into a meeting without taking your headphones off. But like I said, I'm not a big audiophile. I'm really much more into the neurotech stuff, so I'm curious to hear what real headphone connoisseurs have to say about these. Definitely let me know what you guys think down in the comments. Now here comes the fun part. Let's talk about the EEG sensors and the accuracy of the data that Neurable AI provides. Plus some pretty big limitations I've noticed while testing the headphones. These EEG sensors on the ear cups are what actually read your brain waves, and you can see them sewn into the fabric here on the ear cups, but they literally feel no different from the rest of the fabric. They're super seamless and super comfortable. And they're actually really great at getting a good signal right away and maintaining it for long periods of time, which can often be a pain in the ass with the EEG tech. When you start tracking a focus session, you'll select what kind of work or activity you're doing and can immediately start to see your focus levels in real time. When you're highly focused, you'll see tall blue bars, and when you get distracted, they'll drop down to medium or low focus. Biofeedback mode will play some gentle background music that responds to your focus level, but I usually keep this off and play my own music. ADHD type shit. I did notice that certain activities like chewing gum, eating, or walking will throw the EEG signal off and report low focus, so I do recommend avoiding those things while focus tracking. But other than that, let's see how accurate the MW75 Neuro's focus tracking was for me by seeing how my brain responds to watching adult videos versus a proper work session. So I started a focus session around 12:30 p.m. and this was just a regular work session for me. You can see these high blue bars are where I'm in high focus and the lighter blue is like medium focus, not bad. After about an hour, my ADHD kicked in and I decided to give myself a break. I go for a walk, I come back, and my focus slowly picks up for another hour of work. About an hour later, Neurable AI decides to recommend a brain break for me, so I took one. But I decide I've earned more than just a brain break, so I also popped open a bottle of wine and started sipping good. For science. When I returned from this brain break at like 2:56 p.m., I jumped back into work, but you can see that my focus had immediately taken a hit from the booze. The high focus bars are pretty much gone at this point, and we start to see a lot of the yellow low focus bars for the first time. I struggle like this for a while, then I take another brain break and crush another glass of wine. Back to work around 5 p.m., I'm pretty drunk at this point, and my focus is just sucking. So I finish the bottle half an hour later and give myself another little break. Now, with the data you've seen so far, you're probably thinking, there's no way I could get my focus back up, right? Wrong. Because 15 minutes later, I'm starting to feel drunk and lonely, and I'm having some impure thoughts. So I head over to Cornhub while wearing my EEG headphones for science. And now look at those focus bars. Just wow. That is a happy brain. And once my brain is satisfied, it decides to take a nap, still wearing the headphones, which it reported as low quality data, which I guess makes sense. But when I woke up, I wasn't satisfied enough because good science needs to be able to be replicated. So I went back to Cornhub for a research quickie. Lo and behold, my brain is back to super focus.
Science rules.
But the point is, this is just one of many examples where I could very clearly see that Neurable AI was correctly assessing my focus levels in real time, not just showing me some arbitrary bar graph. But this also brings up an interesting limitation. Not all focus is good focus. So how do we work around that, and can Neurable AI actually help you get more work done? I do see two main advantages to using focus tracking while working. The first advantage is immediate and obvious. The brain is a lot like a muscle in that it gets fatigued as we use it, but unlike a muscle, it doesn't have any pain receptors, so we have no way of knowing when we're burning out and becoming less efficient. The whole point of Neurable AI's MW75 Neuro is to check this for us. When we've been working for a while and our brainwaves start to show lower focus, the app will suggest a 10-minute brain break to help you refresh and get back on track. Just taking a few minutes to get outside and get some fresh air, or use the restroom, or just move around a bit can do a lot to help your brain bounce back to work more efficiently. Almost like resting between sets at the gym. The second major advantage of Neurable AI is that over time, the app will be able to offer you valuable insights about your brain and personal work habits. My app tells me that I focus best at night. My best attention span so far has been 38 minutes, which doesn't sound that good. And the quality of my focus is best when tracking the study activity, which is what I designated for when I'm reading. So hey, maybe the best time for me to learn something new is right before bed. This information is already pretty interesting, but I think it can become way more valuable over time with future updates. For example, I think being able to permanently add your own custom activities would enhance user insights considerably. So like for me, I could have script writing, video editing, admin tasks, etc., all as separate categories instead of just work. To make these insights even more valuable, I'd love to see the ability to add custom tags like caffeinated, hungover, or dare I say, horny. Do I focus best after having a cup of matcha, a shot of espresso, or no caffeine at all? Do I work better after going to the gym, or should I save the gym sesh for after work? I'd also really love to see the ability to customize the brain break scheduling. At the moment, breaks are recommended based on an AI-powered analysis of brainwave data, but sometimes I might prefer more frequent breaks. Being able to customize my program with a minimum number of breaks, similar to the Pomodoro technique, is something I'd really find value in. For what it's worth, I already made these suggestions and others to Neurable AI's team and was told that a lot of this stuff is already on the roadmap, so I'm genuinely excited to see how the app evolves and improves over time. But this leads us to a very important question: who should and shouldn't buy the MW75 Neuro? If you do think you're someone who would benefit from this, I'll drop a link down below where you can get a huge discount on the MW75 Neuro, and using that link will also help support the channel, which I always appreciate. So here's how I see it. These are really awesome headphones with really unique and revolutionary EEG technology built into them. They're solid, but at their core, they're still headphones. If you've already got an expensive pair of headphones, I couldn't in good conscience recommend you buy another unless you are really into the idea of using EEG feedback to boost productivity. Also, if you're not someone who listens to music while you work, read, or otherwise focus, this product would be significantly less valuable to you. But if you are in the market for a new pair of headphones, I think these are a really, really cool option, especially if you listen to music while you work. As far as I can see, the headphones themselves seem to be super high quality, the EEG sensors pick up signal extremely well, and the data is accurate as long as you're not chewing gum. If you're the kind of data-driven person who will actually take the recommended brain breaks and use the insights to hack your habits and become more productive over time, then I absolutely think the MW75 Neuro headphones could be worth buying for you. If not, that's cool. Here's a video about one of my all-time favorite products that can improve your health and boost productivity significantly. It's actually really awesome, and I recommend it to my own friends and family all the time, so check it out.